is my commitment to love or to fear. Every single time when you find yourself in a situation where you're frustrated with somebody, and you're frustrated with your husband, with your wife, with your boyfriend or girlfriend or children, you know, and you're trying to force something to be a certain way, ask yourself why. Sit down and take a minute to think about what it is that you're believing about the situation. You know, what it is that you're thinking. And whenever you're acting irrationally or when you're trying to force, I can guarantee you that you are believing and your thought is based on fear, whatever it is that you are believing. Okay, so fear is the act of disconnecting your cord from the only socket that can truly satisfy you and running around trying to plug it in, you know, to somebody else or to something else. You know, and I would ask you to consider this one question as you look upon the whole of your experience. Has it ever worked? You know, it might work for a little while, you know, but sooner or later you'll start being disappointed, you know, by that connection. Imagine that you have water in the palm of your hands and that you go to grasp the water and to hold it. I'm sure we've all done that so many times when we've tried to drink water out of our hands. Or when you cup your hand, you know, the water can actually stay in it. But when you close your hand, you're squeezing the water out. And when you open your hand back, all you're wet, left with is a wet palm, not even enough to satisfy your tongue. You know, but when you allow and when your hand remains open, okay, there is enough water to satisfy you. Okay, so love is like that water. When you grasp it, you actually lose it. And you literally end up squeezing the life out of that relationship, of those relationships. So each time when you've looked upon another person, whether it be your parents, your sister, your friend, your loved one, your teacher, whatever, physical person or object, and tried to plug it into a socket to get the juice that you need, that's just what you're doing. And you literally end up squeezing the life out of that thing. So seek first the kingdom of God. Seek first a relationship with you. And God is in you, okay? When God created Adam, he breathed into him his spirit, and man became a living soul. Irregardless of what your belief is on how we became united or became one with our Creator, we are that. Some people say that we are God and all we are is God, but God is a consuming fire, you know. And when he came down here, he put on flesh, you know, to partake in our experiences and bring us back to an original state, because see, we weren't originally created, you know, with a fallen nature or with a nature, you know, that would have to struggle so much to live in love and to do the things that are good for us, you know, but it was through disobedience. And so now we have opportunities, you know, to press our way, to find our way back home, so, and to be back into a wholesome and a right relationship with our Father. Abba actually means daddy. We can call him daddy. And if you look at the father-son relationship, then we are actually brothers and sisters of Christ. So we are one with that spirit. And it was the last prayer that Jesus prayed, that we would be one, even as he and his Father are one. But not that we needed to become that, but that we would come into a knowledge of it. And once we come into a knowledge of it, then we could become that. We have the ability to. So there are some of us that are not one, and the ones that cannot be one with others are the ones that have not even become one with themselves. So nothing holds a value except your relationship with your Creator. Okay, when you feel God's love, when you're embraced by God's love, is so captivating. You know, it's such a wonderful feeling that it astounds you, you know, and you never forget it. You know, you feel like you can walk on clouds. You feel weightless. you know, and you and the enormity of it all, it can't even be heavy because it's just so wonderful. And words cannot even fully do it justice, you know, but I've been gifted with that presence. And I can tell you how you can be gifted with that presence is by being in the company of God. You know, set aside some time, you know, each day and each week, you know, to spend with your Creator. Get to know Him. It, Spirit. Get to know Spirit. The same way that you spend time with your friends, you talk on the phone to your friends, you meet a guy or a girl, or you meet a, if you're a girl and you're in love with another girl, you know, you have to spend time, you build those relationships, and then you become friends, and perhaps you become lovers. And if you want that relationship with God, and if you want that union, that complete oneness with yourself, then you have to spend time with your Creator. I started keeping the Sabbath when I was age 19, and even though I don't, I've been kicked out of the church a couple times, and won't go back for a third time, I still keep the Sabbath, you know. And so on Saturday, I spend time with God. That's that time that's very special to me. And, you know, on Sundays now, I spend time giving back. So I'm so full, you know, a lot of times, you know, with God's love and anything that He needs to work out in me, you know, we do that together on the weekends, you know. And so I'm refueled and I'm ready, you know, for my week. And I'm so happy to be here. You know, because when you really have the love of God overflowing in you, you can't help but share it. I can't keep all this to myself. It's too wonderful. And because I really do have a great and enormous love for God, I also have a great and enormous love for each and every one of you and for each and everything around you. And even as I speak, I'm going to try and develop a loving relationship with my glasses so that I can read and so that I can find them when I need them. You know, and so that I won't break every pier or, you know, what I do with them. So all you need is love. What the world needs now. Love, sweet love, is the only thing. You know, so remember this, that there is nothing that you can do to bring love to you. Nothing you can do to keep love to yourself. There is nothing you can do to keep people from walking away from you. There is nothing you can do to make love appear in the form of your insistence. Okay, so focus on what is right before you and learn to love everything that is right before you. Your glasses, your hair, your body fat, your beautiful body. You know, your car, everything, the little things, you know. Be grateful and look at a reason why you can love this flower here, you know. I saw it on my mom's house when I first moved here, you know, and I took it, and when she moved, it's broken on that side. I don't care because it came from my mom's house and always reminds me of her. I love flowers. And this is another flower that I have. If you can see it, it's from a client, well, you know, I used to work with teenagers, and one young guy, a black kid, really sweet, gave this to me one day, made it in school, and I've had it for, oh my God, about 9 years now, and it's really special to me. I love flowers, and he gave me a flower that will last forever, you know, and so I was really grateful for that. So when I look at those little things, I come to love those things because they have a sentiment and they're connected to me in a very special way. So